asked a reptile expert, Jungku is looking for rare species on Tibet Plateau. And is staring back at him. The Tibetan hot spring snakes, the highest living snake in the world.
这种高海拔地区是缺氧，外泄非常强烈，在青藏高原这种比较恶劣的环境下，它都能够生存。那么这些适应能力就是吸引我们去研究的一个方向。
The snake's survival against the odds is the story of the creation of the plateau itself, which was situated at sea level eons ago.
现生的文泉蛇，它的最近的姐妹种是生活在美洲的低海拔地区。我们猜测呢，可能是由于青藏高原的隆升，然后而保留到现在的青藏高原面上。Epic
collisions between tectonic plates created the Himalayas. As the mountain thrust up, ancestors of those creatures were separated from their relatives and forced to embark on the cruel path of evolution. Most of their coat-blooded counterparts died due to the drop in temperature. But they survived, relying on a byproduct of mountain formation. Thermal springs strewed across this land. Deep below the surface, the mighty force of nature is still at work today. The turmoil below is reflected in clouds of sulfurous steam and boiled water, feeding its energy to the nearby rivers and streams.
他们利用这个地热温泉的这种热量来帮助他们度过这种青藏高原上比较寒冷的冬天。Hanging
out in those natural sauna looks pleasant, but what's beyond is endless freezing wilderness. Those cozy hot tubs are a haven, but also a prison. The spring also restricts their menu. Today, the snake is taking aim at this alpine frog. Hunting is underway. Waits patiently and approaches silently. A failed attempt.
1964年6月15号是个雄性，全长多少都有测量。对，这应该就是新手发表的这模式。
Li Jiatang and Jiang Ke are members of the second Tibetan Plateau Scientific Expedition, or STEP. The previous mission was in the 1970s, which involved their mentor, Professor Zhao Ermi, the founder of China's reptile research.
包括最初，我们的老师像赵明老师，他们那个年代的话，是用形态学来研究，从形态学的很多方面都回答了这些物种是如何在新高原环境的。这是以前那个西藏的一个。第一次青藏高原科考，对我们包括对整个的生物多样性来说是非常非常重要的，因为在当时的情况下，基本是一个空白。那个年代下的老一批的科学家去调查哪些地方的生物多样性的丰富度怎么样，积累了大量的标本。 从2000年前后，基因组学迅速发展，那使得我们能看一下到底哪些基因发生了改变，使得它能够在高海拔下生活下来。科研研究层层递进，慢慢的在深入下来。Lee's
team was the first to decipher the complete set of genetic information, or genome, of hot spring snakes.
这是高海拔的蛇的基因组，同时我们也获得了低海拔的蛇的基因组，两者比较，我就能看到到底是基因组层面上哪些基因发生了变化。
They soon zoom in on one mutation, which reveals that hot spring snake's ancestors survived the plateau not because they were lucky to come across the hot spring and settled, but because they were genetically designed to do so.
We found a gene called TROP1 in a hot and cold snake. It has a clear difference. In a similar temperature, its就跟别的不一样了，快速能够决断到这个地方是热源，所以他就找到了温泉。
To survive on a plateau, thin air is another challenge, not just for the snakes. Lee's study confirmed that a genetic mutation to overcome low oxygen was shared among species.
EPAS1 基因，这个基因其实在恒温动物里面。像牦牛啊，像这个人啊等等这些物种里面呢是被发现了，第一次在蛇类这个变温动物身上找到了 EPAS1 这个基因的突变。
Mutations also keep their cells stable when exposed to ultraviolet radiation, when other cells would soon break down. That trait shields the snake skin from the unforgiving sun.
我们眼睛看不到的遗传多样性背后呢，西藏的温泉蛇分为了两个比较重要的支系。低的遗传多样性的区域，我们就有花更多的这个精力可以去关注一下。那对保护也是非常重要的。
With the help of genetic tools, scientists can now identify subtle differences between those snakes that are similarly identical. This reminds them.That those creatures continues to evolve quietly. Right here, right now.